Hello friends, today we are going to discuss very important topic, that is genetic drift. We are discussing our module 3rd, that is evolution. So today my topic of discussion is genetic drift. Basically it is a very huge topic, but I am going to define in very simple way. I think that you all will feel very happy after watching this video. Okay, so I have used this figure in my thumbnail because this figure shows the process of genetic drift can be illustrated using 20 marbles. Here you can see 20 marbles are there in a jar to represent 20 organisms in a population. So if you consider this jar of marble as a starting population, half of the marble in the jar are red and half of the marble in the jar are blue. And both color correspond to two different alleles of one gene in a population. Gene is one, but these two colors depict two different alleles in a population. In each new generation, the organism reproduces at random. You can say at random. To represent this population, randomly select a marble from the original jar and deposit a new marble with the same color as its offspring into a new jar. This is the transferring of the alleles. Okay, so repeat this process until there are 20 new marbles in the second jar, means you have to shift 20 marbles from this jar to this jar. Okay, the second jar then contains a second generation of offspring. Here will be the second generation consisting of 20 marbles of various color. Unless the second jar contains exactly 10 red and 10 blue marbles, a random shift occurred in the allele frequency. So, you have to repeat this process number of times, randomly reproducing each generation of the marble to form the next. So, this fluctuation is analogous to genetic drift. I have taken this figure because this example, it is very much analogous to the genetic drift. So, what happens in this fluctuation, it is a change in the population's allele frequency resulting from a random variation in the distribution of alleles from one generation to the next. You can easily see. Here are 5 or 10 red and here 10 is totally extinct. Red color is totally extinct. Or is one species or allele is totally extinct. So in this example, if no red marbles are selected, the jar representing the new generation. So you can say this is the new generation, this is not the older generation. Here is only 3 these types. Full generation is of this type. So, if this happens, the red allele has been lost permanently, you can say, in the population, while the remaining blue allele has become fixed. All future generations are entirely blue. In a small population, fixation can occur in just a few generations, you can say. Okay, so it is very interesting figure. This is the basic figure of the genetic drift. Yes, now. So, genetic drift, it is a change in the gene pool of a population due to chance. It occurs by chance, you can say it is a random fluctuation. Not more common for evolution. Okay, so allele frequency changes are observed across generations. The smaller the population, the more genetic drift has impact on it. So, in one line you can say there will be a smaller population size. Or genetic drift, it is also known as allelic drift or seawall ride effect. When there are few copy of an allele, the effect of genetic drift is larger. Few copy, effect is larger, and when there are many copy, effect is smaller. So there are some features of the genetic drift. It is non-directional. There will be no predicted directions. Random fluctuations in the allelic frequency in gene pool of a small population occur by chance. Increases genetic variation between the population. So, if we are talking about two population, it will definitely increase genetic variations. But it decreases variations within the population. So, these two points, these are the key points of the genetic drift. First, that is, it is non-directional. Direction we can't able to predict and it is always random. Okay. And it increases the genetic variation between the population and vice versa in within the population. Yes. So, genetic drift frequently occur in a small population due to smaller in gametic sample. Thus, greater in chance of its genetic composition will deviate from entire gene pool. There will be sampling error. Why genetic drift frequently occur in a small population? Because of sampling error, or you can say kind of deviation from expected ratio due to limited sample size is referred to sampling error. In a small population, frequency of particular alleles may change drastically by chance alone. Such changes in allele frequency occur randomly, as if the allele frequency were drifting, and are also known as genetic drift. Harmful effect may increase in the frequency in a small population despite selective disadvantage, and favorable alleles may be lost. Even though they are selectively advantageous, it leads to either allele fixation or allele elimination. There may be fixation or elimination. So genetic drift occur in any population. It is particularly likely in situation with founder effect and bottleneck effect. What are founder and bottleneck effect? I will discuss next slides. So genetic drift, it is not goal oriented. It is not having any goal. Genetic drift, it results in loss of allele in isolated population. Okay. So this slide is totally about the mathematical approach. What genetic diversity, what the formula you will use for the genetic diversity? Loss per generation, that is 1 by 2n. Here n is effective population size, and v, that is the variance. V is equals to pq by 2n. Here n is also the effective population size, and this formula is about effective population size, that is 4nf into nm divided by nf plus nm. So nf is basically number of breeding females, and nm is number of breeding male. This formula is basically for monogamous population. Okay, this formula is for monogamous population where sex ratio will not be equal. One more formula, it is previously asked in the CSIR examination, life sciences. So frequency of the heterozygous per nucleotide site at equilibrium between the mutation and the genetic drift, 4n mu naught by 4n mu naught plus 1. N is the effective population size and mu naught is the rate of neutral mutation. There are some causes of the genetic drift, that is the population size is small, sampling error, founder effect and bottleneck effect. This slide is totally about the role of genetic drift in the evolution. So divergence in evolution of gene pool, because breeding population are small and seasonal annual fluctuations are always there. Okay. So finally, we are at the point, very much important, very key point of the genetic drift topic, that is the bottleneck effect and the founder effect. I previously told you these are the causes of the genetic drift effect, that is the small population size, sampling error, I already told you. The sampling error is small population size, founder effect and bottleneck effect. So bottleneck effect. So bottleneck effect, it is a natural disaster may have a drastic effect. Through this diagram, you can easily able to understand what exactly the concept of the bottleneck effect. Okay, so natural disaster may have a drastic effect on the population size, thereby reducing the gene pool size. Survivor may represent certain alleles more than other by chance. Genetic variation of the population is decreased. This may in turn have an impact on the survival of the population. So this is the parental population. Suppose you are going to put these all the specimens or the species in this bottleneck, drastic reduction in the population. These are the surviving individuals. Here yellow color population is more, and here you can see blue color population is more. That is the next generation. So in bottleneck effect, you can say this is a phenomenon of genetic drift where elimination of certain genotype due to presence of strong selection force offered by catastrophic change or natural disaster, you can say. Okay, after the catastrophic change, there will be rebound, new population with the altered frequency, new generation will come. What exactly is founder effect? It occurs when a small number of the individuals colonize a new habitat. Okay, a small number of individuals. Change in the allele frequency relates to the genetic makeup of the founder of the new habitat. In this figure, you can easily understand these are the one species, other species, and this is the mixing. So you can say there will be the, what are the consequences of the founder effect? You can say there will be loss of genotype or change in allelic frequency. It will alter, it will ultimately alter allelic frequency, you can say. Okay. And special type of genetic drift where member of community population migrate to new area. These are the member of the community population, they are migrating to different area. Okay. Thus forming new community or population, this is the founder effect. They are forming their founder population. This is all about the bottleneck effect and the founder effect. And at last, I want to say one thing, that is the allele frequency of the new population differ from the source population. In founder effect, the allele frequency of the new population, it will always differ from the source population, that is the parental population. Okay. And there are some more points about the genetic drift, that is genetic drift in small population, it will always lead to change in allele frequency. You have to learn some key points. It will always change in allele frequency, either increasing or decreasing. It will reduce genetic variation, as I already told you. It will reduce genetic variations within the population. Because of loss of genotype, decreases genetic variation within the population because of loss of genotype. And it will variation increases among the population or between the population by mixing or elimination of the certain alleles, you can say. And here is one more key point, that is there will be fixation or elimination, that is the allele fixation or allele elimination of certain allele which may be either harmful or useful. Fixation of unfavorable, neutral, favorable character in population, genetic drift is not goal-oriented. I already told you. So, stable reproductive isolation between genes of the large population, thus origin of new species. This is also one of the key points, that is there will be origin of new species. A neutral allele, it can be fixed via genetic drift in the population. So, you can say at last that amount of the change in the allelic frequency due to the genetic drift is not directly related to effective population size. What effective population size? I already told you, that is N, 4NF multiply NM divided by NF addition NM. So, here will be number of the breeding females multiply number of the breeding males and whole divided by sum of number of breeding males and number of breeding females. I hope you all have understood this video, this topic very well. Because genetic drift, it is a very huge topic, but I hope you all understood very well because I have explained this topic in very simple way and very interesting way because of these pictures I have taken. So many interesting pictures, so you can easily able to understand. I hope you all will understood. If you feel any problem, you can write me in comment box as your question or query. I will reply. So, it's time to say thank you, friends. I hope we will meet soon.